Swami Vivekananda's inspiring personality was well known both in India and in America during the last decade of the 19th century and the first decade of the 20th. The unknown monk of India suddenly leaped into fame at the Parliament of Religions held in Chicago in 1893, at which he represented Hinduism. His vast knowledge of Eastern and Western culture, as well as his deep spiritual insight, fervid eloquence, brilliant conversation, broad human sympathy, colorful personality and handsome figure made an irresistible appeal to the many types of Americans who came in contact with him. People who saw or heard Vivekananda even once still cherish his memory after a lapse of more than half a century. Swami Vivekananda, known in his pre-monastic life as Narendra Nath Datta, was born in an affluent family in Kolkata on 12th January 1863. His father Vishwanath Datta was a successful attorney with interest in a wide range of subjects, and his mother Bhuvaneshwari Devi was endowed with deep devotion, strong character and other qualities. Although Narendranath's mother was a devout woman and he had grown up in a religious atmosphere at home, he underwent a deep spiritual crisis at the start of his youth. His well-studied knowledge led him to question the existence of God, and for some time he believed in agnosticism. Yet, he could not completely ignore the existence of a supreme being. He became associated with Brahmo movement led by Keshav Chandra Sen for some time. The Brahmo Samaj recognized one God unlike the idol-worshipping, superstition-ridden Hinduism. The host of philosophical questions regarding the existence of God roiling through his mind remained unanswered. During this spiritual crisis, Vivekananda first heard about Sri Ramakrishna from William Hastie, the principal of the Scottish Church College. Earlier, to satisfy his intellectual quest for God, Narendranath visited prominent spiritual leaders from all religions, asking them a single question: "Have you seen God?" Each time he came away without a satisfying answer. He put forward the same question to Sri Ramakrishna at his residence in Dakshineshwar Kali Temple compounds. Without a moment's hesitation, Sri Ramakrishna replied, "Yes, I have. I see God as clearly as I see you, only in a much deeper sense." Vivekananda, initially unimpressed by the simplicity of Ramakrishna, was astonished with Ramakrishna's reply. Ramakrishna gradually won over this argumentative young man with his patience and love. The more Narendranath visited Dakshineshwar, the more his questions were answered. In 1884, Narendranath underwent a considerable financial distress due to the death of his father, as he had to support his mother and younger siblings. He asked Ramakrishna to pray to the goddess for the financial welfare of his family. On Ramakrishna's suggestion, he himself went to the temple to pray. But once he faced the goddess, he could not ask for money and wealth. Instead, he asked for Vivek, that is conscience, and Bairag, that is reclusion. That day marked the complete spiritual awakening of Narendranath, and he found himself drawn to an ascetic way of life. Swami Vivekananda revealed to the world the true foundations of India's unity as a nation. He taught how a nation with such a vast diversity can be bound together by a feeling of humanity and brotherhood. Vivekananda emphasized the points of drawbacks of Western culture and the contribution of India to overcome those. Accepting an opportunity to represent Hinduism at Chicago's Parliament of Religions in 1893, Vivekananda won instant celebrity in America and a ready forum for his spiritual teaching. For 3 years, he spread the Vedanta philosophy and religion in America and England, and then returned to India to found the Ramakrishna Math and Mission. Exhorting his nation to spiritual greatness, he wakened India to a new nation consciousness. He died on July 4, 1902, after a second, much shorter sojourn in the West. His lectures and writings have been gathered into 9 volumes. He is said to have attained Mahasamadhi, and the great saint was cremated on the banks of River Ganga. Vivekananda was successful in constructing a virtual bridge between the culture of East and the West. He interpreted the Hindu scriptures, philosophy and the way of life to the Western people. He made them realize that in spite of poverty and backwardness, India had a great contribution to make to world culture. He played a key role in ending India's cultural isolation from the rest of the world. Here are some Vivekananda awesome and inspiring quotes. "Take up one idea. Make that one idea your life. Think of it, dream of it, Live on that idea. Let the brain, muscles, nerves, every part of your body be full of that idea. And just leave every other idea alone. This is the way to success. Stand up, be bold, and take the blame on your own shoulders. Do not go about throwing mud at others. For all the faults you suffer from, you are the sole and only cause. Take risk in your life. If you win, you can lead. If you lose, you can guide. Strength is life. Weakness is death. Experience is the only teacher we have. We may talk and reason all our lives, but we shall not understand a word of truth. Learn everything that is good from others, but bring it in and in your own way absorb it. Do not become others. In a conflict between the herd and the brain, follow your heart. You should work like a master and not as a slave. Work incessantly, but do not do a slave's work. 3 golden rules. Who is helping you? Don't forget them. Who is loving you? Don't hate them. Who is trusting you? Don't cheat them. Don't look back, forward, infinite energy, infinite enthusiasm, infinite daring and infinite patience. Then alone can great deeds be accomplished. I am proud to belong to a religion which has taught the world tolerance and universal acceptance. We believe not only in universal toleration, but we accept all religion as true. Never think there is anything impossible for the soul. You cannot believe in God until you believe in yourself. You are the creator of your own destiny. Talk to yourself once in a day, otherwise you may miss meeting an excellent person in this world. Throw away all weakness, tell your body that it is strong, tell your mind that it is strong, and have unbound faith and hope in yourself. All power is within you. You can do anything and everything. Have faith in yourself. All power is in you. Even the poison of a snake is powerless if you can firmly deny it. Arise, awake, and stop not until the goal is achieved. How did you like the video? Please comment. Don't forget to share the video. Please subscribe VCAN channel.